happy.
Nation, we're back.
2010 Daytona 500 champion Jamie McMurray will be returning to the NASCAR Cup Series. That is right. You heard me right. I did not expect to talk about this really ever, but here we are. Last week we had Pitbull becoming a NASCAR owner. This week we got Jamie McMurray returning to the Cup Series, returning to NASCAR inside the car. He's been a Fox analyst the past couple of years. He's been like in the studio. You know, he stands on next to the green screen with all the graphics and stuff, and he talks about stuff. I think he's called a couple races, correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, he's been working with Fox Sports for the past couple of years, hasn't raced since the 2019 Daytona 500, and he will be racing in the 2021 Daytona 500 and the Spire Motorsports number 77, sponsored by Advent Health. Advent Health has been a sponsor for Chip Ganassi Racing for the past few years, and they have sponsored Kyle Larson, Jamie McMurray, Kurt Busch, I think it's one point, and in the future, or even Ross Chastain. Remember last year, Ross Chastain was in the number 77 for Spire, and Spire and Ganassi have worked together in the past, and so Chastain, he's been kind of the guy last year and the past couple of years that Ganassi was really grooming to be their next driver. If Larson ever left, or if Kurt Busch ever left, something like that, they were kind of grooming Chastain to be the next driver, so they put him in the 77 car last year for a couple races. I think the Daytona 500, the Coke 600, and a Kansas race. They put him in the car. It was the 77 car, so it was still a Spire Motorsports car, but it had some Ganassi backing in terms of sponsorship, and I think they sent some guys over to do some Ganassi stuff. They were like, here's some extra parts or something like that. I don't know all the details, but yeah, that's going to be a... That was helpful for Chastain, as he is now the driver of the number 42 Chip Ganassi car. But Jamie McMurray, he's not a bad driver. You know, he's got 7 career wins. He had a 3-win season back in 2010. He hasn't won since 2013 at Talladega. But and also he's a good plate racer. I'll tell you what, he's got a few plate races. I'm having struggling to talk today. He won the 2010 Daytona 500, as I said at the beginning of this video, 2013 in Talladega. So he has one in a Gen 6 car. I think he's got another Talladega or Daytona win too. But yeah, Jamie McMurray, he hasn't had a bad career. I mean, obviously it wasn't like a big, crazy, great career, but it wasn't bad. He still had some race wins. He had some good seasons. So Jamie McMurray's a solid driver. He seems like a good guy. You know, he seems like he's enjoyed his time as an analyst, but I guess he wanted to get back in the car and they gave him the opportunity. He said, yeah, sure, why not? We can do this for one race. So yeah, Jamie McMurray is back in a car. He will be with the number 77 Spire Motorsports. Remember, Spire Motorsports earlier in the offseason decided to expand to a 2-car operation. Corey LaJoie will be in the number 7 car full-time. Corey LaJoie will be a full-time driver in the number 7. But Jamie McMurray will be in the number 77 for the Daytona 500. Now, as for the rest of the season for that car, I don't know. I think it's a charter. So I think he gets in no matter what. If not, he's going to have to qualify his way in, which means, you know, he's going to have to qualify well. And then he's going to have to do well in the Daytona duel. So I'm pretty sure Spire has charters with... what's his name? LaJoie having a full-time season. I'm not sure about the second car, though. Correct me if I'm wrong there. But yeah, I don't know who's going to be in that car the rest of the year. People thought it was going to be Justin Haley because Justin Haley, obviously, Spire Motorsports 1 win is from Justin Haley. He's driven their cars in the past. He drove them last year. He drove them, obviously, 2019 when he won the Coke Zero 400 in a rain-shortened race. So people thought it was going to be him. I personally thought that second Spire car would go to Justin Haley, but... Jamie McMurray in the Daytona 500, that's a shocker. He hasn't raced full-time since 2018 when he was in the 1 car for Chip Ganassi Racing. And then 2019, obviously, he just raced with the Daytona 500 in the number 40 car, and he hasn't raced since. But I'm kind of curious to see how he does just because, you know, you look at the Daytona 500 field, and they're... You know, super speedway racing is unpredictable. You don't know who's going to finish in the top 10. You don't even know who's going to win, to be honest. But, you know, like Trevor Bayne won the Daytona 500 in 2011, right? That's 10 years ago this year. Trevor Bayne, Daytona 500 champion. But then you see, Like, the past couple of years has been Denny Hamlin, Austin Dillon, like, guys that have won before, like, won cup races before. But, you know, you start to go in the top 10, and you're like, oh my gosh, that guy got a top 10, you know, like, maybe a couple front row cars get a top 5 or something. You see Corey LaJoie in the Go Fast Racing car get a top 10. You see Timmy Hill up there in the top 10. He didn't finish in the top 10, but he was running top 10. But, you know, plate racing's so unpredictable, so who's to say Jamie McMurray's not going to do good? He could survive the day and get a top 10, top 5. Heck, he could win his second Daytona 500. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you for a fact he is, but I think it's a real possibility. I mean, Spire Motorsports has got to win Daytona. I mean, I don't care if it's rain shortened, the win's a win, but I'll be curious to see how he does in that car, see if he can get it up front, see if he sits in the back, waits for everything to happen, go for the win, or if they try to get up front all day. But yeah, I'm excited for Jamie McMurray. I like him, so if he wins the Daytona 500, that would be a story, man. But yeah, we got more news other than that. That was the main topic of this video that I wanted to talk about. McMurray's return to NASCAR, obviously. Now we just need to get another Fox Sports guy back in the car. Jeff Gordon, you need to get back in a car and race. It doesn't have to be the Daytona 500, but get back in a cup car, Jeff, please. That'd be epic. Like, maybe a new track that they added this year? Any of them? That'd be cool. Anyways, back to the other news. We've got Ty Dillon. Ty Dillon, last few years of his cup career, he has driven for Germain Racing, the number 13, Geico Chevrolet. Well, that team shut down last year just due to COVID costs and stuff, so they weren't able to continue on, so they shut down their operations after being in the Cup Series for a while. Even had some trucks. I think they had some truck series teams in the past, but obviously that made Ty Dillon a free agent. He didn't have a ride coming into this year. He wasn't sure where he was going to go. You know, everything had been filled up really by the time that they had announced it. You look at the Hendrick car was all but filled. Everyone kind of knew it was going to be Larson. The Penske team had all been re-signed or was under contract. All the big teams, at least. And then even some of the smaller teams, Front Row had already announced, or at the time they knew it was going to be McDowell, John Hunter Nemechek, and then obviously John Hunter Nemechek decided to leave. But, you know, everything was kind of in place. It was really hard for Ty Dillon to get a spot, but there was a couple rides open. But they weren't great, but he's going to be in one. So it's going to be Gaunt Brothers Racing, the number 96 last year. They missed the Daytona 500 with Daniel Suarez when they crashed in the dual race. But they had a pretty solid season, I would say, with Daniel Suarez. Daniel Suarez currently in the Trackhouse car now. He decided to leave Gaunt Brothers for the Trackhouse car, I should say. But Ty Dillon will be moving to this team. They had a pretty solid year last year. They had a couple top 20s. Really ran 23rd to 28th, which isn't bad for them. So they had a pretty solid year last year, I would say. They are an open team, so they are not guaranteed a spot in the Daytona 500. They are going to have to qualify their way in. They're going to have to qualify well. They're going to have to do well in the duels, all that stuff. But Ty Dillon's going to be driving that car. I tell you what, this is another one of those guys who at super speedways could do good. You know, the Gaunt Brothers car isn't great. I'm not going to sit here and tell you that that thing's going to run the top 10 all day. It's not. That's a fact. It's probably going to be mid-pack or the back, but if it survives a couple of crashes, it could get a top 10. And then Ty Dillon is actually a pretty decent super speedway racer. You look at last fall at Talladega, the last super speedway race we went to. He finished third, I think. It was top. He got a top 5. I know that because it was like the best finish in Germain Racing history or something. It was like third. But Ty Dillon did good that race. He was running up front. He got a top 5. Then the year before, 2019 Talladega, he was restarting on the second row. You know, pushing Blaney for a bit, I think, until Blaney ended up winning. I think he finished 6th, 7th, or 8th or something. But he's not a bad super speedway racer. I'm not going to sit here and tell you Ty Dillon's terrible, Gaunt Brothers is terrible. I'm not going to say that they're going to win, because I don't think they're going to win. But I think if it came down to it at Daytona, You got a low underdog team. If they survive, they got a pretty good driver for super speedways, Ty Dillon. He could sneak on up there and get a top 10. I think he could. I think he very well could. We all know super speedway racing. We all know the Daytona 500 is chaotic. It's the biggest race in NASCAR. who knows what could happen? There could be a 20-car pileup. I mean, seriously, crazier things have happened in the Daytona 500, so it's very possible they do well together. I'm really happy for Ty Dillon. Ty Dillon, I think, is a decent driver. I think he deserves a shot in a decent car, but, you know, it's unfortunate that the whole Germain thing happened with them shutting down, and he was left kind of just like, where do I go now? So I hope he's able to get a better ride next year. I think this is just a one-race deal. Or maybe he could, you know, be a substitute driver. You know, if a driver has COVID issues, I hope that doesn't happen. But, you know, if it happens, maybe Ty Dillon could step in and race a car and kind of prove, like, hey, I can drive. I'm a good driver. But he will also have sponsorship from Bass Pro Shops and Black Rifle Coffee, according to Bob Pockrass. So, yeah, he's got some sponsorship with him. That's always a good thing in NASCAR. If you have sponsorship, you're doing something right. Last thing I wanted to talk about is Cole Custer. He has a new sponsor, Dixie Vodka. Remember, they sponsored the Homestead race last spring. It was supposed to be spring, but ended up being summer because of the big Ronas. But anyways, as I was saying, they are now sponsoring Cole Custer. They're going to be a primary. I think it's for the Daytona Road Course, and they will be an associate sponsor for the rest of the season. So there's another new sponsor in NASCAR. So good. Good for him. Good for Stuart Haas Racing. You know, that's good for them, I'd say. But, you know, also some other, just quick news. I don't really need to talk about it that much. It's just kind of simple. Hair and skin product company Mane & Tail will sponsor Quinn Howe for the Daytona 500. I'm sorry. Dixie Vodka is primary for Nashville and the Daytona Road Course. But, okay, back to other stuff. Josh Balicki to drive full-time in Cup in 2021 in the 52 Rick Ware Racing car. So we got Rick Ware Racing's drivers are Joey Gase and Josh Balicki confirmed, out of what I know, for the full-time rides. Oh, boy. I'm sure you guys saw this, but Taylor Gray, he's an ARCA driver. He was at Daytona. I guess he was doing some testing. He decided to pull out his phone going 180 miles an hour and started filming it. Yeah, he got fined $1,000 and he's on probation for 2021 for doing that. So, yikes. If you're a NASCAR driver and you're watching this, I doubt there's any NASCAR drivers watching this. Don't pull out your phone in the car when you're driving. It's bad. They banned phones from the cockpit overall when Keselowski took that picture in the 2013 or 2012 Daytona 500 when they were parked. But don't do it while you're driving. That texting and driving in general is bad, but especially in NASCAR. That's bad too. Just don't text and drive, okay? That's my message to everyone. Anyways, that's all I got for today. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Yeah, we'll do a paint scheme. We'll do multiple paint scheme videos on 2021 paint schemes. One later this week, maybe one in a week or two after that. So yeah, look out for that. Have a great rest of your day. As I said earlier, like, subscribe, share, all that stuff. Bye.